Hi, Teri here from Stamping Magic. Welcome back to my channel. Today's project is another masculine card. I've used the Handsomely Suited stamp set together with the coordinating suit and tie dies and also some of the well-suited designer series paper. So let's get started. These are all the measurements you need for all the elements required to create this project. So if you're interested in reproducing it, take a screenshot so you can refer to it later. This is the Handsomely Suited stamp set and I'm just using one sentiment today. I'm using my Stamparatus for the stamping so I can overstamp and get a nice dark impression. I'm stamping on normal weight basic white card. I've positioned my stamp and picked it up with the plate. And now I'm going to use Knight of Navy ink to ink it up and stamp it a couple of times. The sentiment will be punched out using the tailored tag punch. And I'm also going to punch out from a scrap of real red cardstock. I'll then cut through the red tag long ways and use the two pieces to back my sentiment panel. I'm adding glue along the top and the bottom edge of the sentiment panel and then I'll place the real red pieces behind them just so there's a tiny border of red showing. I have a small scrap piece of basic white card here that I'm going to colour to make the neck and I'm using my Ivory Blends marker for this. All the other pieces that I need to make up my card have been die cut using the suit and tie dies. I have a piece of the well-suited designer series paper here. And this is the same size as my card front. Now I've used this long die to create both the shirt placket that goes down the centre and the braces. Now the braces and placket are just the right size for A4 users, but if you use 8.5 by 11 inch card as your standard, you will have to trim them off just a little bit at the bottom. Then I've used both the pocket pieces dies, again cutting out designer series paper from the well-suited, and I'm going to tuck my pocket under one of the braces. This is completely optional, you could leave it off if you prefer. There's a little button die that die cuts 6 buttons and I've die cut that from Knight of Navy card. Then from silver foil, I've die cut the little brace clips and you get 2 of those dies, so it's just one pass through your machine. I've used the smaller bow tie die for my tie and I've used the oval centerpiece. I've also die cut the collar from designer series paper and you can see that die on the top right. On my original card, I added these silver strips, and I think they're sort of braces guides. I'm not sure what they're called. But I used the little pocket strip die for this and did some partial die cutting. You want to place your die over one end, and I used 3 stitch marks as a guide. And then I just ran it through my die cutting machine, and this way you get stitching all the way round. And then I added it to the other side and repeated it to get the 2 pieces. I've added mini dimensionals to the centre of my bow tie, the little centre piece, and also the 2 points of my collar. My card base is in Knight of Navy, and this is half a standard sheet of card, scored in the middle and folded to create a portrait card. For inside the card, I have a basic white mat, and I'm going to decorate the bottom of this with a strip of Knight of Navy and a strip of the matching Designer Series paper. Thank you. And that's it. That's my card complete. It's really very simple and quite quick to do. And here's another look at my original card. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed this project. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and hit that notifications bell so you don't miss out on any future videos. Bye for now.